That's why this golden word of God is written in the book of Philippians, chapter 1, verse 29. Can anyone of you read? It is good that you read. Philippians chapter 1, verse 29.
For he has graciously granted you the privilege not only of believing in Christ, but of suffering for him as well.
He has given us the privilege not only to believe in him, but also to die for him, but also
of suffering.
To suffer for him. To suffer for him, a special grace is given. Special grace is given to suffer for him. Have you heard this good news? Why special grace is given?
To bear the suffering.
To suffer for him. If you go and preach, come, God will give you a lot of suffering. Nobody will come further. Eh? So today, where everywhere we go, blessing gospel. Come, one car you have, God will give you two cars. In one of the meetings, I heard one servant of God said, all those who brought water, lift up, everything is going to become wine. And somebody drank and said, came and gave witness, yes, it has become wine. The enemy has entered into the church, taking away the truth and the heart of the gospel and giving it in such a way which are pleasing to men. Jesus knew it. That's why he said, in the last days, people will be preaching that which is pleasing to one another. The truth will be hidden. And the truth is this. Jesus took up the cross means, he took up the mission of the Father. He took up the cross means, he threw himself, his whole life, into the hands of the Father, that the Father's will may be fulfilled in the world. And today, he is asking us, take up the cross. Those who wish, those who love me, you are kept in a particular place where God's salvation is needed. I don't have anybody except you. You are placed there. Like me, you will die. Like me, you will carry the cross. Like me, you will be humiliated. Like me, you will be forsaken. Like me, you will be misunderstood. You will not run. Maybe even your life, you will die. You will offer and fulfill the will of the Father. My mission will be fulfilled here. God is calling people to take up the cross means to bring forth the vision, the mission of God in the place where they are kept up. Through you, let the will of the Father be fulfilled. You are unique, you are precious, and God has chosen you. And he has a dream about you, that you will not hold on to yourself, you will not hold on to this, but you will surrender to the Father. You will take up his cross. And of course, there is one more stage. We have little time. He says, take up the cross and follow me.
Follow.
Means who is ahead of us?
Jesus.
We keep Christ before us. With ourselves, we can't suffer. So, we carry the cross and keep Christ before us. And Christ goes and we look at him. When we suffer, we feel like running away, but we look at Jesus and we go ahead. That's why in the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 1 and 2, it is written, read the word of God.
Therefore, Since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely.
Let's throw away all that doesn't belong to God, and then?
And let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer, and
throwing away the sin and all that trying to blackmail you, give wrong impression of following the Lord. You have to throw away, choose Him, and then
let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us.
Now, what is set before you? What do we call it?
The race.
What is set before you? What is the meaning of it? What is set before you? What do you call it? The vision, the mission. Each one of us are unique, given a new mission, a unique mission. God has given you talent, and why did He give you some particular talent? To fulfill that mission. He has not given to me, He has given to you. What He has given to me, He has not given you. Not that He shows partiality. No, He knows that you are cut for a particular purpose. And to fulfill that particular purpose, what are the things needed? He has endowed with you. He has given with you that type of body, that type of things. Once I met one of my spiritual guide, an SVD father. He told me, "I knew, man, you will become a preacher one day." I said, "Father, how do you say?" "How did he say, Father?" "Because you used to be a very good basketball player." I said, "You have said something and you are saying now something else. What is the meaning of that, Father?" "Yes, every guy will run away, but you will be playing and playing, lot of stamina." Now I understand. God knew that you have to serve Him in this ministry, for which you need stamina. So He led you into that. He could have made you into carom players, kurcho. Or He could have got the interest in playing cards. He left everything. He gave you into the basketball. God knows for what purpose you are called.